Hello and greetings from Iceland. Today I have both good and bad news, and I'm going to start with the bad news. Since we have now lava flowing over the lava barriers again, from where it's only 1200 meters to the power plant, so the water cooling is helping out, cooling the lava in order to make the work easier for the bulldozers. So this is a team job now, to prevent the lava from flowing to the power plant, since, like I described in my last video, I can't emphasize enough how serious it would be to lose this battle now. And it has been confirmed that the large water pumps have been bought, and they are on the way to Iceland. So this might turn into a huge water cooling operation, like the one that rescued the harbor in Westman Islands in 1973, and actually a part of the town as well. But it is very unfortunate that the land around here, it leans towards the power plant. And if it wasn't for those barriers, it is likely that it would be gone already. The lava runoff that occurred on June 7th, it turned out to be an extremely unfortunate addition to the lava that came up during the first 2 days. And we thought back then that we were over the worst, but it wasn't the case. So the project we have now is to make a new lava barrier behind the existing barrier to capture the spillover lava and cool it down, to slow it down, to buy more time for the bulldozers. And will this do the job? That is a $100 million question. Over 1,000 jobs at stake, 3 hotels, a power plant that keeps 8% of all houses warm in a land called Iceland for a reason, and the biggest tourist attraction in the country. If the power plant goes down, so does the Blue Lagoon. So the stakes are extremely high. But luckily, we have some good news. The eruption might have stopped 4 o'clock this morning. No tremors have been detected since then, but we might still have to deal with some of the existing lava ponds that are present by the crater. But not this continuous lava flow, constantly pushing this pile of lava toward the power plant. But it might, however, take a few more days to see this stop, if the eruption has indeed ended, so we are still not on safe ground. But if we can fight this for a few more days and stay on top of this, that might be the time that you need. But the main risk is now the huge amount of almost liquid lava under those piles, or lava that can take off quite fast, making this job very dangerous. But I am going to be so optimistic to say that we might be about to win this battle. The lava can perhaps move a couple of hundred meters more towards the power plant. But if the eruption has stopped, it won't be long until this solidifies. And I have other good news. When we look at the ground uplift, the curve isn't as steep as it has been, backing up what some of our scientists have been saying, or the inflow into the magma chamber, or the main crane. So it might be the case that the experts that predicted this to come to an end in September were right after all. But it's too early to jump to any conclusions. The ground uplift speed will become more clearer in the next days, especially if the eruption has in fact stopped. And if it is the case, the magma that is solidifying now will be the landscape that we will be stuck with for the next 800 years. But the seismic and volcanic unrest, it will continue elsewhere on the peninsula instead. And the seismometers have already a pretty clear story about where that might be. But more about that later. Things will still remain hectic here. And I want to say thanks to Chris for the footage and leaving a link to his blog in German. I am up north right now. Just got my car from repair that didn't work out as well as I hoped. So the local Toyota dealer here will take it in a few days to analyze the problem better before I hit the road once again. And until then, there are several new videos on the way, plus that I will of course be all over this lava outburst that is teasing us now. And with that, I'm sending you best regards from the volcano island, Iceland.